Good morning, everyone, and I hope everyone is staying safe and healthy. I know this pandemic, which is there with us since 2020 March, that actually happened after our conference, which was there in the February. I think luckily we escaped that, and afterwards, you know, we are really suffering here now. But like, you know, we thought we are going to start this webinar series from, this is the first version of this one, and we'll be starting the session. And today we invited our friend Madhavi Santosh. She's the author of the famous book, Unconditional Self Love. And recently the book got launched here. And thank you, Madhavi, for accepting the invitation here to be part of this first webinar series this academic year.
And thank you, sir.
Yeah. And today, I will take around 15 minutes maximum. Then the Madhavi madam will take over the thing here, talk. Now, today I thought, like, now I thought of showing a small antidotes, you know, this pandemic thing here, everyone got like, you know, demotivated, and like a lot of stress is taking place. And in a lot of places also I have seen here, the close friends or relatives or, you know, family members, like, you know, they lost in this pandemic here now. So by keeping all this in mind here, I've just picked up three antidotes which will help us to understand. So I think I'll show a small presentation to all of you. Yeah, you know, like, just first we'll talk about this power of hope. This is the real thing happened in 1950s. Kurt Richter, a professor at John Hopkins, did a famous droning rat psychology experiment. You know, this experiment, through a cruel demonstration, the power of hope and resiliences in the overcoming difficult situations we all going now. He placed rats in a pool of water to test how long they could tread water. On average, they give up and sink after 15 minutes. But right before they gave up, due to exhaustion, the researchers would pluck them out and dry them off, let them rest for a few minutes, and put them back in for a second round. In the second try, how long do you think they lasted? 60 hours. That is not an error. Conclusion is that since the rat believed that they would eventually be rescued, they could push their bodies way fast, what they previously thought impossible. If hope can cause exhausted rats to swim for that long, what could a belief in yourself and your abilities do for you? So let us inject hope in ours and everyone's life. And believe my words, and this pandemic is not going to be throughout our lifetime. Maybe 6 months, maybe 1 year, nothing to worry about that. And today we need to believe in ourselves. So I think that this, if you got a hope in yourself, I'm sure that you are going to overcome all this, whatever the difficulty that we are facing now. I'll share the second thing, association. This was beautifully explained by Swami Vivekananda ji. And a raindrop from the sky, if it is a caught, what is going to occur, by clean hands, is pure enough for drinking. If it falls in the gutter, its value drops so much that it can't be used even for washing your feet. If it falls on a hot surface, it will evaporate. If it falls on a lotus leaf, it shines like a pearl. And finally, if it falls in an oyster, it becomes a pearl. The drop is the same, but its existence and worth depends on whom it is associated with. And please believe, it is said that one is known by the company he or she keeps. Always be associated with the people who are good at art. You will experience your own inner transformation. And believe me, if you think, because nowadays you have seen, like if you open the TV, a lot of negative news is coming here about the pandemic, that third wave coming, fourth wave coming, etc. like that. And please don't believe all this word. Only thing is that you need to keep the good people around you and trying to improve the immunity. And I'm sure that, and always be positive about the life, and definitely nothing will happen to you. Everything will be all right. So this association is very, very important. And always talking or thinking about only the positive sense for any situation, that is a more important. I am sure that this is going to helpful to understand how this association is very, very important. And now the last one, I'll just take this third one, which is called inspiration, you can call. A king had many elephants, but one elephant was very powerful, very obedient, sensible and skillful. Everything especially is fighting skills. In many wars, he was sent on the battlefield and he used to return only after getting victory for the king. Therefore, he was the most loved elephant of the king. Time went by and there came a time when the elephant started getting old. Now he was not able to perform as before. Therefore, now the king did not even send him to the battlefield, but he still remained as a part of the king's team. One day, the elephant went to take a lake to drink water, but unfortunately his feet got stuck in the mud and he went on sinking. He tried a lot, but he could not remove himself from the mud. People came to know from the sound of his scream that the elephant was in trouble. The news of this elephant trapped also reached the king. All the people, including the king, gathered around the elephant and made various efforts to get him out. But alas, even after trying for a long time, there was no way out. At the time, Gautam Buddha was passing by. Gautam Buddha stopped and inspected the site of the incident and then suggested to the king that the battle drum should be played around the lake. The listeners felt shocked at the major suggestion as to how the trapped elephant would come out by playing the battle drums. But they could not say anything to Gautama Buddha and started playing the drums. As soon as the drums of war started ringing, there was a change in the gesture, behavior, and determination of the troubled elephant. At first, the elephant slowly stood up and then gradually used his force and intelligence, and before long came out of the mud on his own, shocking everyone. Gautama Buddha smiled and said, "There was no lack of physical ability in the elephant, but only the need to infuse enthusiasm, motivation, and will within it was missing. To maintain enthusiasm in life, it is necessary that humans maintain purposeful thinking and do not let despair dominate their thoughts. In today's tough times, we all need to enthuse ourselves and people around us with the hope and enthusiasm by playing, if need, with the battle drums, that we will again celebrate abundance of joy, health, and happiness today. Remember, these two shall pass." And I'm sure that you all agree with me, because these three small antidotes will give a lot of, you know, motivation to all of us. And I'm sure that, like, you know, we are going to come with the same situation which was before March 2020. And college is going to start. The students are going to be in the campus. Maybe it will take 6 months. Maybe it will take 5 months. Maybe it will take 9 months. But I'm sure that we all going to come. And this, we are going to prosper. And I'm sure we are going to celebrate this abundance of the joy, health, and happiness here. Now, this I thought of just sharing with you at this difficult time of situation in this case here. And stay safe and always, you know, the wear mask. We are in the group, something like that. And always, you know, take care of your health and be happy, and nothing will happen to you. And believe in yourself, believe in the God. I wish you all the best to everyone, so that we can able to come out of all this stressful life, whatever that you're passing in this case. And thank you very much. And I request Madhavi Garu to take over the dais. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for that wonderful, inspirational speech. And thank you for that wonderful story that you spoke about. It was really, really very nice. So much. A very good morning to everyone, and welcome to this session. I'm so glad that all of you are here, and I'm so excited to speak to all of you. So today's session is about motivation and keeping yourself up in the game, okay? But we all feel down, we all feel low, we all feel miserable, especially during this pandemic time, as Chinnam Reddy sir was saying. This is the time we need to actually understand our true potential, what we are actually worth and how we can actually build ourselves. It is during the troubled times that we build ourselves to the maximum. So let me just start off with a story. I had gone to Rishikesh and I was on this trip. I love adventure sports and adventure activities. So I had gone for a bungee jumping. People who do not know what is bungee jumping, you stand at the edge of a mountain cliff and they tie you up with ropes and you jump off. It's a very, very scary, scary situation. You have to jump on your own. Nobody is going to push you. Okay. I remember standing at the edge of that mountain cliff when I had to jump. I was fighting fear completely. I was fighting everything inside me. My mind was telling me, you can't do this. Do you really need to do this? Why do you want to do this? Do you really need to prove anything to anyone? At that time, I just turned back to the guy standing behind me and putting his hand on my back, telling him, can you just push me? He said, this is bungee jump, not bungee push. If you want to jump, you have to jump on your own. So I had to be my own motivation at that time. So that was the key point where I understood that this is the place I need to motivate myself. I need to push myself and I need to do what has to be done. So when I was standing at the edge of that cliff, my mind was constantly telling me so many things, continuously telling me so much of negativity. I just stopped and looked at it like a movie. You all can do this actually. Every time you have a negative thought or something that pushes you down, stop and look at that thought like a movie. Look at it like it doesn't belong to you. When you watch a movie, what happens? Suppose there is a major accident that has happened in the movie. Do you really feel like as if you are going to be affected by it? No, you know it's in the movie. You know it is there. It is not going to harm you. You just watch it. You do get emotional, but you know it is not going to affect you. So look at those thoughts like a movie. When I stood there and looked at it like a movie, automatically, guess what happened? My mind became blank. Everything stopped. And I jumped. I leaped. And you know what happened? The fear was there only till the point where my legs left the board on which I was standing. After my legs left the board, the fear also left. And I just flew. It looked like I was falling, but I was feeling like I was flying. Each and every one of us needs to understand this. Understand that you have potential inside you. And it is only the fear and the lack of motivation that is pulling you behind and not letting you be your true potential. No matter who you are, no matter where you are, no matter what your situation in life is, you have potential in you. So you all are going to college and you are studying and you have teachers, lecturers, gurus who take care of you, who motivate you every time, who pull you up during the times of your lows and who give you the clarity that you want. But what do you do when you are sitting at home and you are not getting that kind of motivation which you would get when you're in person in the campus? What do you do at that time? You become this new person. Let me just share screen and show you what I have for you. Yes, you be your own guru. This is something that I learned as I grew up. You be your own guru. What is you need to do? You need to motivate yourself. You need to show light to yourself. You need to see the path that you want to travel and take that path, even if you are afraid. Understand one thing very clearly. Fear is not going anywhere. No matter what you do, you're going to feel afraid. But guess what? It is okay to be, you feel afraid. I feel afraid. Each and every one of us has fear. Lack of motivation also comes with fear. But if you are your own guru, if you are motivating yourself and telling yourself that, yes, I can do it. What does your teacher or lecturer do? They tell you that you can do it. You can be your best potential. Be your own guru. How often do we forget about the potential and the abilities that we have? We don't even know what our abilities can be. So this is a test, okay? This is a test that has been done by the top universities, and you can do this to yourself. No matter how much do you think your potential is, or how much do you think you deserve? Usually, for example, if you think your potential is X amount, for example, if you think your potential is X amount or you deserve only X amount, generally your potential is X plus 10. You deserve X plus 10 in your life. Whether you believe you will get it or not is a different thing. But your potential is X plus 10. Always understand this. Whenever you start to do something, understand this very, very clearly. That potential is X plus 10. Keeping that in mind, go ahead and do what you want to do. Automatically become your own guru. Automatically, you know what you want to do. Automatically, the path in front of you becomes clearer and clearer. Don't expect to know everything in one go. Life is a learning journey. So keep learning, experimenting, keep failing, keep falling. It's okay. You have always got another opportunity, another chance, another way of proving yourself. Never discriminate or put yourself down. We feel that outside people discriminate us, or outside people tell us wrong things. But it is actually our own mind that tells us the maximum negativity. The maximum putting down happens by our own mind only. How many times do we keep thinking negative, keep thinking continuously negative thoughts? Many times we don't even know that we are thinking negative. When we know what we are thinking, we can decide what we want to think. Let me repeat that again. When we know what we are thinking, we can decide what we want to think about. If you don't know what you're thinking, if your mind is on autopilot, continuously running, not understanding what to do, how will you know what you want to think, how you want to feel, how you want to motivate yourself, and how will you be your own guru? Yes, question yourself. Start questioning yourself now. Start questioning yourself and come to the solution of things. That is where I want to ask you. Who are you? Are you a person who has to run day by day finishing your work? Are you a person who needs to just finish work and not enjoy life? Are you a person who has to just live through life and not understand it completely? No, you are a person who is here to experience life to the fullest. I will become this 10 years later, 20 years later, no matter who you are young people, young students. You are the people who can mold your life completely right now. But if you don't live in the present moment right now, experiencing it to the fullest, you will never get to live life to the fullest. And even if you reach your goal, you won't enjoy that goal. Why? Because you did not enjoy the journey. So experience life to the fullest. Keep one eye on your goal, but experience the present moment to the fullest. That is who you are truly. Who else are you? You are here to feel the joys and live life in a high state, higher state. Yes. Which means what? Living life in a higher means what? Looking at the positive in everything, feeling good about your life, feeling good about yourself. I want to tell you one more story. I had gone on a solo trip to Nepal. Chinnam Reddy sir knows about this story, actually. I had gone to Nepal on a solo trip. And as I told you, I love adventure sports and activities. I had gone there for waterfall rappelling and whitewater rafting and all these activities. So when we were ready to go for our activities and when my guide was tying me up and all, guess what happened? The entire earth under my feet shook. The mountain on which I was standing in Nepal shook. The adjacent mountain shook. Nepal was under a massive, massive earthquake. Nepal was attacked by an earthquake. And I was standing right in the middle of it. Standing there, there was a profound realization in my mind. I realized that I might die over here and nobody will know, because there was no way I could tell anyone what I was going through. I was all alone and I had to survive. That is where I understood the true value and true worth of my life. So start today to understand the value of your life. Starting young is even better. Starting and understanding the value of your life, understanding what you truly are, who you truly are, what gives you happiness, what gives you joy. Don't look at other people. Don't look at film actors and sports persons and other people who do so many things. Their likes, their interests are different. Yours are different. Why? Because you are unique. You are the only person who looks like you on this planet. Do you know that? There is no one else who looks like you. You're the only one with your unique DNA and your unique retina. So focus on understanding yourself. Get that profound reality that you are special. You are unique. You can do the best. You can be your guru. Don't wait for one earthquake to make you realize that you need to do something with your life, or don't wait tragic to happen for you to understand, no, now I need to live my life. Start today, start now. That does not mean you need to do something very big. Start with small baby steps. Start doing the things that give you joy, that make you feel joyful, because that is where the experience, true experience of life is. So when you start studying and when you start doing mix, then you start enjoying that also. Because that starts becoming a joyful thing to do. Because your joy is always, you know the value of your life. Yes, so start understanding the value of your life and be joyful and keep doing the things that give you value and give you joy. The next thing is, we are here to live a wholesome, complete life with all the ups and downs. We all want to play safe. We don't want the downs. We only want the ups. And after some time, we don't even want the ups. We just want a straight line. Let everything be safe. Let everything be easy. Let everything be smooth. I don't want to risk. I don't want to take risk in my life. But facing those risks, facing those downs is what makes your ups even more exciting, makes your ups even more joyous. During this COVID situation, there are so many people around me who have been affected by the coronavirus. So many of the people around me who have passed away because of the virus, close people I know have passed away, and it has been tragic. I feel truly blessed that I am healthy and safe, that I am able to keep myself healthy. So feel that feeling of gratefulness and thankfulness for your life. Last year in the month of August, my husband was affected with COVID. The whole month went in that entire quarantine and taking medications and taking care of him. He was going through a different kind of stress and I was going through a different kind of stress, because I had to take care of him and I had to take care of myself also, and I had home. We both were the only ones, and it was so difficult for both of us. Struggling through the COVID pandemic and trying to make it through. We got so much of help. We got a wonderful doctor who was telling us what exactly to be done. The entire treatment happened at home. During that time, I could have felt demotivated and given up and started complaining and cribbing and crying. We generally do that. Start getting angry and irritated at every single thing. If this glass was kept here instead of here, I could have got irritated. If this thing fell, I could have got irritated. But at that time, I was thankful that my husband is recovering. I was thankful that I am there to take care of him. I was thankful that even though I was being with him, I did not get affected. I did not get affected at all. I was so thankful and grateful for all these things. So those downs actually made us reflect on our ups. Right after he got recovered, we felt so good that he has come out of the situation and both of us are healthy. Now we are building our business, motivating people, coaching people, doing so many things. Because we did face a lot of downs. So every time you are feeling down, understand that it is okay. This will also pass. And this has something even more wonderful coming your way. Don't expect everything to be up. Don't play safe. I would tell you to go ahead. Take the risk. Do the things that you love doing, no matter the risk, because that will give you the true happiness. Make you live your life to the fullest potential. You're not here to just live your life day to day, eat food, sleep, watch TV. You're here to do more. You can do all those things. Those are survival things. You are here to do more. You're here to live your life to the fullest potential. Yes, we only use 5% of our brain. We don't use the rest of the 95%. Even the most intelligent people use maximum 70% of the brain. So when we use only 5% of our brain, we are able to accomplish a lot. Imagine when you use 10%, 20%, 30%, 50%. When you use your brain to the fullest potential, I'm not talking about going crazy. I'm not talking about becoming crazy and forgetting how to live life. I'm talking about living to your fullest potential. If you use your brain and ask it for answers, ask what I need to do, how I need to do, your mind gives you all the answers. Your mind tells you everything. Trust me, because I have been there stuck, not understanding what to do, feeling demotivated. And when I asked my mind, what do I do? How do I give my best? My mind gave me. I was never this person who could sit like this and speak to you with confidence. Never this person. I built it slowly and steadily, giving love, giving appreciation to myself, giving that self-care to myself, nurturing myself, building myself, falling and failing. Understand this. Your downs will be pushing you towards your ups. Yes, you have the ability to create the kind of life you want. We all have the ability to create the kind of life we want. Don't adjust. Don't settle for something less. You have it in your hands to create your life. That person is supposed to do this for me. That person is supposed to take care of me. That person, he did not do this. That's why I could not be who I am. She was not very supportive. That's why I did not do. You know what? I wanted to, but I could not. Don't end up there. Trust me, there are many people who have these regrets. I wish, what if, I should have, I could have. Don't end up there. Start today, start now. You have the ability to create the life that you want. Yes, how do you keep yourself motivated? Creative ways to keep yourself motivated. These are all things I do for myself. I give it to a lot of my clients. You can do this for yourself whenever you do 3 things that you like in a day. Whatever you like. Maybe it is your hobbies, or maybe for a walk, or maybe it's just sitting and doing nothing. Do 3 things in a day which make you feel good. What happens with this? You sharpen your axe. If it is work, work, work all day, or if you're just lazing around, not doing anything all day, your brain becomes numb. You know, you have a supercomputer up here. If you had the mind of an animal, of any other animal, it is okay. But you have a supercomputer over here, a human mind. And that mind wants to be its best, can do its best if you keep sharpening the axe. So do 3 things that you like in a day. Maybe go for a walk, speak to someone you like, spend time with your hobbies. Maybe you like painting, singing, dancing, whatever it is. Sit and have a nice cup of tea or coffee. Sit and do the things that you like to do. Meditate. That is another thing that you can do. Any 3 things. And you don't need to spend hours and hours behind it. 2 minutes, 5 minutes, and then go back to doing whatever you are doing. That actually sharpens your axe, rearranges your brain, and makes you ready to do more, to achieve more, to put your best. Yes. The next is spend time listening to relaxing music, not to high beat music. Listen to that, but spend some time, maybe just 5 minutes, listening to relaxing music and listen to it completely. Don't play it and forget it in the background and go ahead and do something else. Don't start surfing the net while playing the music. Listen, whatever music you like, let it be any music, whatever music you like, listen to relaxing music. So in the morning, every day, I play relaxing music and I sit and meditate. So that actually makes me feel so good, sharpens my axe and makes me give my best wherever I am. Yes. The next thing you can do is listen to yourself. Listening to yourself means what? It's not about listening to yourself means going crazy in the brain. Listening to yourself is understanding what are the thoughts that we come. This is a very, very deep topic, but let me just tell you superficially. Your mind has 60,000 thoughts in a day. 60,000 thoughts. And most of those thoughts are repeated thoughts. So if you want to change what you think, listen to those thoughts. Listen to what exactly is going on. Most of those thoughts will be negative thoughts because our mind is wired towards negative. Why is it wired towards negative? It's survival instinct. If we think negative, we can keep ourselves safe. That is how our mind is wired. There is a lot of science behind it. I won't want to go into it right now. I'm just giving you the gist of it. So listen to your thoughts. What are the negative thoughts coming in continuously? Do you really want to think these thoughts? Do you really need these thoughts? Are they helping you? Are they making you become better? Or is that thought just giving you a dopamine rush, making you feel good when you're thinking bad about someone else? It happens. Yes, we think that that person was like this. I should, you know, that thought comes in our mind and that dopamine rush happens. We start feeling good, but that does not last long. Even a positive thought can give that dopamine rush. If I start thinking about a holiday I want to go to, of course, during this pandemic, it's not possible, but the pandemic is not here forever. We are going to go on holidays. We are going to go on trips. If I start thinking about a holiday, then I start feeling good. That same dopamine rush comes. That same feel-good factor comes. So listen to your thoughts. Listen to yourself and shift it. Yes? The next one, spend 1 hour daily on planning your future. We are all in this rat race today. We just want to finish off today. We all are in this rat race. We are trying to finish off today. Just spend 1 hour in your day, no matter when it is, whenever you have free time. Just spend that 1 hour in planning your future. Planning means what? How do I want my future to be? It should not be boring. Something exciting. What is it that you see yourself as? How do you feel when you are seeing yourself that way? How do you want your life to be? How do you want your life around you to be? Not just you. Think, plan, imagine. Plan that thing. Just 1 hour daily. Start off and start planning your future. Planning your future does not mean making one big thing, writing, I want this, I want this, I want this. Just sitting and thinking for yourself. How do I plan my future? What is it that I want? Write it down in a book. Keep a journal and write down the things that you like, that you would like to have in your future. This is your age. This is the best time for you to start planning your future. Start planning it. And that is the best way you can have everything you want. Yes, we all like to live on the edge, but living on the edge does not help us. We end up nowhere. Planning actually helps us live a better life. Yes. And show self-love. This is something that I have been coaching so many of my clients. I've been coaching people for the past 10 years on this. Okay. Show self-love. You want to be healthy, you need to show self-love. You want to do great in your studies, you need to show self-love. If you want to be your best, you need to show self-love. You want to have good relationship with your family members. You want to have great friends with you. Show self-love. Why? Because everything around you begins with you. If you're not there, your life doesn't matter, right? You are there. That is why your life matters. So give that love and that respect to yourself. Find that respect for yourself and do things for yourself that show self-love. Yes, speak respectfully about yourself. Love yourself. Care for yourself. Take care of everything in your life and yourself. that will actually help you lead a better life, lead an amazing, relaxed, peaceful life. You are no more struggling and trying to get things done. You will see there will be other people who are struggling when you are actually relaxed, doing all the work, enjoying the day, and also getting time to enjoy all the things that you like to do. How amazing is that? Yes, these are the creative ways you can motivate yourself. Use these things to have that amazing, abundant life that you want. Don't wait for getting things done in the last minute. Yes, getting things done in the last minute is something that everybody does. But be that person who plans ahead so that you are less stressed. You are having everything you want and living your life to the fullest. Yes, so let me share some easy ways you can have everything you want in your life, get your life set, and not get demotivated as you move through life. Yes, easy ways out. Plan your day. Easy way out is actually the tough way is to just doing whatever is there. Let me finish this work. Let me finish this work. By the end of the day, you must have faced it. Half the work won't be done and whatever is done won't be done 100%. I have faced it. I would try to get so many things done and I would not be able to do it. So many things in my hand, I would not be able to give my 100%. It was even affecting my sessions like these where I've had to speak. Because in my mind, continuously, I was going on about, oh, I have to finish this, I have to finish that, I have to do that work. So much in my head. So I started planning my day. When I need to do what? Just give that time and plan your day. It is more relaxing, more easy. And you can actually get a lot more done. And you know what you can get done and what you don't can't get done. And what you need to do the next day. Yes, the next is sleep well. This is something everybody gives less priority to. We all want to end the day with one Amazon movie or a Netflix movie. We want to get up and first thing in the morning, we want to check our Facebook and see how many people have liked our page or liked what post we have put. How many people have liked that other person's post? We are all busy with that. Yes, the first thing we want to do in the morning is open our social media and check that. But the sleep that you have is very, very important. That is what is helping you do the things that you need to achieve that goal. It is easy to sleep, right? We should not struggle to sleep. It is a basic need for us. Every animal on the planet sleeps. So we also need to sleep. Sleep well. What does it do? It sharpens your axe. It makes you fresh for the next day. You're more lively, less irritated, more enthusiastic about the day, less uncertain. You are more motivated. And you are less crying and crying. Yes, every morning you get up, you need to feel good. You should not get up and first thing that comes to your mind is not, I need to do this, I need to do that. No, get up with that good sleep and you will see that how relaxed you are throughout the day. Improper sleep, improper day. Yes, simple and straight. The next, keep your goals and dreams alive. Live in the present moment, as I told you, but keep your goals and dreams alive. Now, I'm talking to you, I'm motivating you, I'm speaking, it's feeling good. After the session, the motivation starts dropping down. It starts coming down. So don't demotivate yourself there. Keep your goals and dreams alive. When you keep that eye on that goal and that dream, as you're living your life, you keep motivating yourself. If you lose track of your goal or that dream that you want, you automatically don't know why you're doing all the things you're doing. You don't know why you're living day after day. You lose track of what you are actually supposed to do. And you start doing so many other things. Keep one eye always on that goal or that dream. Keep it alive, no matter what the situations. As you go, during this pandemic time especially, we feel that a lot of things cannot be accomplished. But let me tell you something. We need to get creative. There are always ways for you to achieve something that you want. There is only a different way to it. Yes, there is never a closed door. There is only a different way to it. So I was conducting such sessions in person and I was doing it only in Hyderabad. It was really difficult for me to every time conduct it only in Hyderabad and not outside Hyderabad. I could not reach the audience outside Hyderabad. And when COVID and pandemic happened, I could have still continued or I could have just stopped my business because I cannot go anywhere. But I shifted online. I learned the tools and techniques. I learned the softwares. And now I'm able to coach and train people all over the world. I have clients in US, UK. I'm able to motivate people everywhere. This is my dream. I felt it and I wanted to do it. What is yours? And how are you creatively achieving it? Look at that. Yes, the next is dance your way through life. Now, we all think that we have to be serious and very strict and very disciplined. You need to be disciplined, but you need to dance your way through life. Look at your problems, because one day, trust me, one day you're going to look back and laugh at those problems. Oh, I went through this. I did that. When I sit and look back at my Nepal journey, the earthquake that I was stuck in, I went through severe depression during that time. I became a person who locked herself in a room and would not meet anyone. I did not see anybody after I came back home for 3 full days. I was suffering severely, physically, mentally, emotionally. But today I look back and I just feel like I went through that also. I did that also and I came out. I'm just dancing through all this. So dance your way through life. Does not mean you stand up and start dancing or go on the road and start dancing in the middle of the road. Dance your way is keep that dancer in your mind alive, which means be alive, be active, be enthusiastic, be energetic about life. No matter who you are, no matter what your situation is, no matter if people around you are supporting you or not. Not everybody will support you. Get this straight. Because they don't understand what you want. You understand what you want. So get clear about that and dance your way through life. Yes, do things with a purpose. This is such a big thing. Why am I drinking this glass of water? Because I'm thirsty. Why am I eating food? Because I'm hungry. That is the purpose I'm giving. I'm not just doing it blindly, right? So same thing, whatever you do, give a purpose to it. Suppose you have a goal and dream, and for achieving that dream, I need to do this particular thing. Then why am I doing this today, right now? Why am I doing this? Why am I studying this particular subject, or why am I doing this particular task? Give a purpose to it. It could be something very, very small or something very, very big, no matter what it is. Until and unless you do not give a purpose to something, you will never find the enthusiasm to do it. Trust me on that. Or you will do it for now, you won't do it tomorrow, you won't do it day after. The consistency will be lost. If you want to do something, find the purpose behind doing it. Yes, and always choose happiness. Whatever you're doing, don't forget that you need to choose happiness. Why are you doing everything you're doing? To be happy. That is the main goal in life. Not to struggle, not to suffer, not to compromise. We do everything in our life to ultimately be happy. If you're not happy doing what you're doing, then you need to revisit. Look at what you're doing wrong, tweak it, change it, work on it until it makes you happy. Yes, that is the way to live your life completely. If you are struggling through life, stop and look at it. Give it a purpose. Dance through life. It's okay if there are downs, there will be ups also. Be your own guru. Keep motivating yourself. Give yourself the life you deserve, because you can do X plus 10. Your potential is that. If you feel you can only do X, your potential is X plus 10. So give that X plus 10 advantage to yourself. Yes, everyone will come and go. Everyone will tell you that, yes, you can do things. No, you can't do things. Everyone will tell you a lot of things. What is your mind telling you? What is your heart telling you? What is it that you want? Forget about everything else. What is it that you want? So I would like to end with a story. I was doing my genetics. I'm a postgraduate. I've done my MSc in genetics. And when I was doing my MSc, one of my lecturers wanted me to do a particular course, which I was doubtful about. My heart, my intuition was telling me no for that course. Because what I felt was, I will only get the certificate, but I will not get the experience. They just wanted me to showcase a certificate, but I wanted to learn something as I do that particular course. So what happened was, I said, no, I will not be able to go ahead and do this. So she made me stand in front of everyone and she called me a loser. There will be times in your life where people, things, situations, maybe family, maybe friends, maybe people around you will tell you things that you will feel low about. You will not like, you will feel not so good about yourself. Trust me, when I was standing there and she was calling me a loser in front of everyone, I did not like it. But other people's opinion of you does not have to be your reality. This is something told by Les Brown. He is one of my mentors and he is a top coach in the world. Other people's opinion of you does not have to be your reality. I want you to take this away today. Do not let other people's opinion of you change how you look at yourself. You are the best. You are whole. You are abundant. That's it from me, Madhvi Raju, your complete lifestyle coach. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to speak. And thank you so much for letting me put my best potential in front of you. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. That was wonderful.
Nestled in a sprawling campus, spread across 26 acres in the IT district of Hyderabad, National Institute of Tourism and Hospitality, NITHM, is one such institution that is preparing world-class professionals for more than a decade. NITHM is the only institute of its kind in India which brings together the different faculties of tourism and hospitality to offer an integrated learning experience that is at par with the global industry standards. The picturesque campus with lake and forest offers a perfect backdrop for budding minds to sharpen their skills and get ready for the challenges ahead in the industry. The institute offers undergraduate and postgraduate degree courses and short-term diploma and certificate courses in hospitality and tourism. At NITHM, emphasis is given on providing a world-class professional environment driven by theoretical and practical exposure. That is why learning here goes beyond the classrooms. The institute boasts of live kitchens, mock rooms, labs, and a state-of-the-art culinary infrastructure that makes sure that the students are industry-ready even before they start working. But the grooming does not end here. In order to develop the mental strength, interpersonal skills, and communication skills of the students, NITHM offers a host of other facilities and training modules in order to help them become an all-rounder in their field. In just 14 years, NITHM has emerged as a credible institution which the industry trusts to hire the best talents. Our alumni are ruling the hospitality and tourism industry. They are holding our flag higher across the world and making us proud every day. National Institute of Tourism and Hospitality Management, nurturing excellence, serving success.
There are few questions like that. People are asking. One of the participant asked, I always sleep. Because of pandemic, I don't have anything else to do. I always sleep.
Dr. Hemant, can I just interrupt? Your voice is not heard actually. Can't hear it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can you hear me now, ma'am?
A little bit more. Actually, the voice is very low.
Just give me a second. I hope you can hear better. Yeah, there is a question by one of the participants. I always sleep because I don't have anything to do in this pandemic. I always sleep. So this is the question. So Can you tell something what they can do or help them? What, how they
Achai,
can
I can't. Achai, you're asking me a question?
Yeah, yeah.
I can't hear. I thought you're saying something.
There is a student who asked a question.
Okay.
He said, I always sleep because I don't have anything to do.
Uh-huh.
So can you suggest me something, he's asking?
Yeah. So there are two reasons why we sleep. One is because we need rest, and the second is because we want to avoid something. So what is it that you're avoiding? I would like to ask her. That you're avoiding, that you're sleeping so much. There is something you need to do, something you need to go and do. I'm asking you, questioning you directly, whoever has asked that question. I'm asking you directly, what is it to do? I've given you, get clear about what your dream is, what your goal is. I spoke about that. Go, write down, what is it that you need? Maybe there is something that you're afraid of or you're postponing regularly. So that is because I have done it. Okay. I would always, there are certain things like supposing I have to look at my finances. I find it very boring. So I will say I'll look at it tomorrow. I'll look at it later. And I would always find some or the other work which will keep me busy and not let me do that thing. So in your case, you're finding sleep. So if you do something with a purpose, if you get clear about what is it that you are missing out and what you truly want to do, your sleep will automatically get adjusted. Yes. Are there any you can feel free to ask questions so that, you know, I would love to answer. In the meantime, I'm just sharing my website link and my book. I have written my book, Unconditional Self-Love, sharing a link of that. You can just go and look at that also.
Great.
Please feel free to ask questions.
Ma'am, I don't know why they're not asking you in the chat box. I'm getting on my messages like this question.
Maybe they're comfortable with you. That's a good thing.
So, one of the students is telling he has planned everything since last 4 years. Like when he joined the course, he planned something. Last 3 years, then after the last 2 years due to pandemic, he can't perform well because of pandemic or anything. So all his plans went into like gutter, he's mentioning. So how he needs to rebound, he's asking.
Good question. Thank you so much for that question. So there is something we all want and there's something we are working for. Yes, there is something we all want and there is something we are working for. Somewhere, what we want and what we are working for is not coinciding. So that is why life is throwing challenges to us to direct us in the direction towards what we want. So a child goes to a shop and wants chocolates. So the owner of the shop takes the bowl of chocolates and just presents it to her to pick up the chocolates and pick up as many chocolates as she wants. She says, you pick it up and give it to me. So the owner takes out and gives the chocolates to her. So her father asks her, why did you tell the owner to take out the chocolates? You could have picked up as many as you want, right? No, his hand is bigger. He will give me more chocolates than my small hand will be able to take. So yes, we make plans, but there is something unfolding for you. Don't give up. The same dreams can be achieved in a different creative way. Maybe the path needs to change. Maybe you need to change the way you do things. Like I told you, I was doing the in-person coaching. But when that stopped happening, I started doing online. So when I started doing online, automatically my market opened. Now I can coach people all over the world. And I'm doing that. And that was actually my dream. I was fighting. Not understanding how I'm going to do that, traveling to so many places, traveling out of country and all. But now I'm able to do it. So keep your mind open and let things flow. Let ideas come. Yes, you made plans. Now we need to work on those plans. Change it a little bit, tweak it a little bit, whatever it is. Yes. So the result also will be 10 times better. All right. I hope that answered the question.
Yes, ma'am. I got two questions. Anyone wants to ask anything, ma'am? Like
I am absolutely free, absolutely open. Please go ahead, unmute and ask whatever you want.
You can ask her.
I'm not going to bite.
Guys, in the meanwhile,
type in the chat box if you're finding it uncomfortable. I know people would rather shoot themselves rather than come in front of the camera. I know that fear. If you are afraid, type in the chat box. Yes?
Yeah, that's better.
I have shared the link for my website and my book. You all can just click on.
Yeah, please. Please go through the link where ma'am already sent her link in the chat box. Please save it. That will be useful for you guys for your future.
questions, please go ahead.
In the meanwhile, can we have a group photo?
Oh, wait, yes.
Everyone. Please switch on your cameras so that we can have a group photo.
Yes, there's a question that has come. We can always do that after the group photo.
Yeah. So in the meanwhile, we can have a group photo. Just give me a second.
Again.
Yeah, one photo has done. Second one is getting ready. So please, everyone, please turn on your cameras, I request, so that we can have a better photos. One more. So, yes, sir, that's done for the moment. Any questions, guys, please ask.
There is one question by Raghu that has come. Ma'am, any suggestions for us how to become better in this pandemic situation? So the question you need to ask Raghu is, what should I do to become better? So what is it that you want to do to become better? Yes, how you will become better will automatically come if you know what to do, right? I want to go from here to Vizag. I know where I want to go. How I need to go, I will decide by car, by flight, by bus or whatever. But where I need to go, what I need to do, I need to get clear, right? So what is it that you are wanting to do? And then I can tell you how you can become better in this situation. Yes? So for example, if in case you want to become better at your academics, that is the most common thing. If you want to become better at your academics, or if you want to improve your skills, any skills you want to improve, start searching for people who are teaching. Start finding ways in trying to learn and understand. Don't undermine anyone. So when I started on my coaching journey, I took coaching from a lot of people. I have worked with the top coaches, and I've also worked with people who are not in the top. I was ready to work with anyone and everyone to grab knowledge, to get information, to improve my skills. Yes. So there was this one lady who had actually just started off a coaching. In fact, she should be taking coaching from me, but she proposed that she will coach me. Usually what we would do is we would go into a ego spiral. We would feel that, oh, how can she coach me? But I actually went ahead and took her coaching. I took it and I learned a lot from her. Doesn't matter what the source, even if there is one small idea that you learn from someone, one new thing you learn, it is worth going to that person. Go and start absorbing knowledge. Type on Google. Keep checking on Google. What are the things that you need to do? How to up your skills? How to improve yourself? Check. You are in an age where technology is at your feet. Use it to the fullest potential. Open your Facebook and type, I want to learn this. Anybody can help. Go ahead. don't feel scared that people, what people will think. People respond. If nobody likes this poster, nobody responds, what will I do? Don't think that way. Just go ahead. Tell everyone, I need to learn this. I want to know this. How do I get to know this? You'll get a lot of people who will pull you down. Let me tell you this straight away. But eventually you will get what you want. You will become better. Pandemic or no pandemic. Yes?
Yes, ma'am. That's wonderful. So, guys, any more questions?
Any more questions? Okay, wait a minute. People have asked me. They're asking me. They are liking me also. Okay. Ma'am, this is S. Ravan. Okay. Ramesh, what challenge you have taken in this industry? Okay, what are the challenges I have faced? Madhvi, you're not good enough. Madhvi, don't do this. Madhvi, what is that you're talking? Madhvi, you're boring. Madhvi, stop it. Madhvi, teaching profession is your thing. You're a woman. Teaching is your profession. You should be in teaching. This is what I was told. I did teaching for 6 years, by the way. I was a lecturer by profession and then I shifted my profession. Although it is a noble profession, it was not something that I wanted to do. Each and every one of us, my whole family is into teaching and there are lecturers and principals in my family. I did not want to do. I wanted to do something else, something more, and coaching resonated with me. Yes, I faced a lot of issues. People told me that wasting your time. You're a woman, you can't go far. These are the things people told me. So if you're facing problems and situations and people telling you things, understand one thing, you're on the right track. You're going ahead. That is when people will tell you something. If people are not telling you anything, people are not hurting you, that means you're sitting in your comfort zone. All right. Yes. Next was, hi, ma'am. This is Deekshita. I had a job in an event company. I'm a person who likes working for events, but not the same with my parents. Now I am not working. Any suggestions? Okay. This is one big thing when it comes to clash with your parents. So somewhere you are not standing up and showcasing to them that you are a responsible person. You are showing to them that you are an irresponsible kid. See, try to understand your parents still think of you as that small child who couldn't walk or that small child who needs their support. Yes, they have been guiding you for so many years. Suddenly to let go is difficult for them. But you need to showcase to them that you are a responsible person. Start getting involved in the home. Start getting taking decisions in the home. Get involved with your parents. Speak to your father. Speak to your mother. Hiding, keeping quiet, staying stuck in your room and crying and thinking that I never get my dream is not going to help. Speak to them. Not about this. Maybe this is hurting them. This is not something they are comfortable about. Speak to them about their finances. What are the problems they are facing? How are they running the house? What is the thing? What is getting cooked today? Speak to your mom. What is getting cooked today? See how, what are the things, take responsibility in the house. Slowly and steadily make it in such a way that they come and ask you for suggestions, ask you for opinions. They take it, they do something about it is secondary. They ask you for suggestions, they ask you for opinions. Automatically what happens, they start believing in you. They start understanding that she has matured. Okay, I think she can handle herself. So what I did when I was in my teenage, I used to go for treks and trips. My parents used to get very scared. For 1 year, they used to find it so difficult. Every weekend, Madhvi was out. But slowly and steadily, they started seeing my photos. They started seeing the places I went, the things I did, the activities that I did. Then they started believing that, oh, she can handle everything. Applied for the armed forces. I had a dream of, at one point, I had a dream of going into the armed forces. I applied for it. They told me, no, all that happened. I went ahead and I did it. And I got rejected and I came back. But what that actually did was, it made my father say, oh, you handled that much of problems. I think you can handle things now. So you know what happens? They need trust. They want to you to build that trust. You won't trust anybody and everybody, right? You need to build that trust. So build that trust and get confident about yourself. you can take right decisions. You get confident first. Na? Why are you thinking you are taking a right decision or wrong decision? Get confident about yourself. Speak confidently. Get involved in the home. Speak to your parents openly. No matter what they say, don't take everything to heart. Take everything to face value and move forward. Have a thick skin. Yes? Have a thick skin and move forward. All right? I hope that answered your question. All right, wait. What is your motivation line? Okay, 1 minute. What is your motivation line? I didn't understand. Who is this? What is your motivation line, Ramya? Please clarify what you meant. Ma'am, where you want to see your after 5 years and how you want to achieve that goal. Okay, from after 5 years, my 1 year goal is I want to impact 1 lakh people's lives and transforming their life. My 3 year goal is to go ahead and speak, become a speaker at TED Talks. My 5 year goal is to go to all the big countries and speak there and motivate people. My dream, my vision in 5 years is I see myself walking onto a stage and an auditorium full of people, lakhs and lakhs of people. I can't see them. They look like small, small dots. And I'm standing and I am speaking and motivating. That is my dream. That is my 5 year dream. Yes, I see that in my mind. For that, today I start. Today I do this. Today I work on it. Yes. So keep clear, start visualizing your dream, get clear about it and work on it. Okay, best words given to you from your seniors in this industry, ma'am. Best words from, okay, I don't believe in advice, okay? I believe in failing and learning, all right? People have told me a lot of things which I have taken and not taken, but the best teacher is life. Life will teach you everything. And life will give it to you in such a beautiful way that you will never forget. Yes. Okay. So there are a lot of people who told me a lot of things, but there were a lot of people who motivated me and pushed me also. They made me stay in the discomfort zone. And that is exactly why I could keep myself in discomfort and push myself forward. Change does not come in the comfort zone. Yes. Thank you, ma'am. If we are successful in any way and have personal branding, then only we can coach and mentor others, right? Is it correct? If you have the dream, if you feel you can do it, that is all that matters. It starts from you. Branding comes, what do you say? Having a standpoint comes later. Being a successful coach in the industry comes later. Everything comes. But first, you need to believe in yourself and you need to know that you can do it. Without that, everything else does not happen. Nothing happens. All right. Whatever your dream, first, you have to start believing in. Okay. If you are successful. Okay, this is done. I think all questions are done. Any more questions, guys? I'm feeling excited now. I'm on fire to answer questions. Any more questions? Yes. Ma'am, you wish to work alone or you will work in a group. I have my team. I work with my team. My husband is a part of my team. Seeing my commitment and my motivation, he also has become a part of my team and he's motivating and supporting me. I have my own team. I have my digital marketing team, photography team, but everything was not there. First, Madhvi was there. Madhvi started and went ahead and then everyone else came. Yes, I have my team. I work with other coaches. I coach along with them. Today, I coached with Chinnam Reddy, sir. He is an amazing coach. He is an amazing motivation. Whatever he spoke, listen to that and go, that there is so much of value in what he said. Look at that also. Yes. So I do groups. I do individual. I do a lot of things. Yes, Raghu. Any other questions, guys? Ma'am, what is your strength? My strength is me. Yes. Your strength should be you. Nothing else is going to stay with you. Everything will come and go. Your strength is you. That's all. Yes. I want this, the technology, that laptop, this book, that studies, this course, everything later. First strength is you. Yes. Next. All right. So what I'll do is, if in case you guys have any more questions, I'll drop in my mail ID. Mail me and I will reply back. I've just shared my mail ID with all of you. You can mail me and ask me any doubts, any queries you want. You can go through my website and see all the things that I have, all the different coaching programs I have. You can pick up my book. That is a good start for you to motivate yourself and up your game and be your best potential. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
The best part in your life in this industry, the best part is right now. Past, present, past and future is gone right now. I'm enjoying this session. This is the best part. Yes. All right, guys. Thank you so much. Dr. Hemant?
Yes, ma'am. That's wonderful. Actually, participants, hopefully they have good energy, like drinking Complan or Boost afterwards. They'll get some energy. By listening to you, they might have got 100 times more energy. And thank you so much. Even you have energized the participants. And even I learned many things.
Thank you so much.
Is necessary. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you, Madhavi.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. And thanks for everyone's patience for listening. And this, I hope, even if one person benefited from this session, my work is done. I am here for that purpose. I want to impact people in the most positive way. And even if one person has felt that impact, I feel grateful for it. Thank you so much, everyone, for this opportunity. Thank you so much for I'm here and I'm able to do my best. Thank you.
Thank you.
National Institute of Tourism and Hospitality Management. Nurturing excellence, serving success.